are going to talk about social work. This is the first introductory course of Bachelor of Social Work, where we are going to talk about the introduction to social work. As social work is described to be a helping or therapeutic profession, it should have its knowledge base on the different social sciences like sociology, psychology, political science, economics, and other social sciences. It draws from various perspectives of understanding the individuals, groups, cultures, communities, socio-economic and political perspectives for a better understanding of the social problems. Social work is a discipline as well as a profession. It involves the application of social theories to have a better understanding of the society and people. It applies therapeutic processes and methods to deal with social and individual problems. Social work is concerned with the causes of social problems, its impact on the individuals, groups, communities, and to deploy social work methods for its solution. Therefore, social work comprises of a multidisciplinary approach to understanding the societal problems. Social work differs from other social sciences because it is considered to be a profession. The word profession means that it consists of certain skills and artistry. It is grounded on the ideas of social sciences, but it goes beyond to the next level of application of therapeutic models to deal with the social issues. The profession of social work uses skills, techniques, and related methods to address human needs and modifying human behavior, and hence it is also known as an applied science, because it not only tries to understand the theoretical perspective, but also goes beyond to the next level of exploring therapeutic models for solution of the social issues. Now let us go to the next slide that talks about definitions of social work. How social work has been defined by different groups and persons. The Indian Conference of Social Work defines social work as a welfare activity based on humanitarian philosophy, scientific knowledge, and technical skills for helping individuals or groups to live a rich and full life. Therefore, this definition indicates that social work involves a humanitarian approach to help people with the use of scientific understanding and skills. When we say scientific understanding and skills, it means the use of research, the use of techniques that social work profession utilizes for understanding societal issues. Social work is a process that deals with directly and differentially with persons who have problems relating primarily to their social situation, and which endeavors individual to individual to understand what help is needed and to assist the individual to find, utilize the help indicated. So this definition was given by Friedlander in 1951. This definition says that social work is a process that links resources that an individual can utilize to solve the issues relating to social situation that surrounds us. So therefore, a role of a social worker here is to act as a resource mobilizer. With the available resources, whether an individual is able to have access to the resources and try to solve the problems that is at hand. Now, let us see the objectives of social work. The profession of social work has certain objectives. What are objectives now? Objectives are statements or formulations of what we are trying to do in social work. Some of the important ones are, number one, to solve psychosocial problems. Here, psychosocial means an individual is a composition of not only his physical being but also of the mind. So when a crisis is faced by an individual, it is not only psychological in a way or not only social, but it is both a composition of psychosocial aspects. So the objective of social work here is to try to address the psychosocial problems that an individual faces. Secondly, to fight for social justice. Social justice is something which social work gives much importance. Social justice is a way of fighting against injustice and also to deal with or to reach the justice for a particular issue or an evil that needs to be eradicated from the society. Thirdly, to fulfill humanitarian needs, it can include both charity, welfare, as well as rights-based perspective of social work. To solve adjustmental problems and enhance individuals' growth and development. Here, adjustmental problems indicates not only the societal environment, but also the individual's internal conflict that a person is facing. Only by solving these adjustmental problems, a person can have proper growth and development in the mind as well as in the body. Fourthly, to create self-sufficiency. To create self-sufficiency as an objective of social work, here a social worker links a person with the available resources and to make him or her independent or self-dependent. To integrate and coordinate the means and resources of social development. There are many resources in the society, but it needs to be properly linked. It needs to be coordinated for addressing the social as well as individual issues. Second, to develop democratic values and make provisions for corrective and recreation services. Democratic values, as stated in the Constitution of India, social work is a profession that follows them, and it is the objective of social work to ensure that these values are credited to the individual's development. To bring change in the social system. A social system which is sometimes weighed down by certain traditional values, certain beliefs that are not rational, needs to be fought against. So here, the role of a social worker is to bring about a change in the social system which is not good for the society or which needs to be eradicated. To provide socio-legal help, it is also directly linked with the objective of providing social justice. Social legal help is not only providing psychological and social help to a victim or to a person who is seeking social justice, but also providing or connecting him to legal help or advocating for the client when a person is seeking social justice. Now let us see the main motto of social work. As it is stated, helping people to help themselves. Here we are talking about empowering the client. Helping people to help themselves is a perspective which focuses on not only empowering the individual, but also help him understand his strength and the way how he or she can reach or develop oneself without being completely reliant on the social worker or someone else for the particular objective. Functions of social work. P.D. Mishra, who is an eminent social scientist, had categorized social work functions based on the following criteria. First one is curative or remedial function. Under the curative function, the following services are provided: medical services, health services, services relating to psychosocial and mental health, psychiatric service, child guidance, child welfare services, services for the handicapped and the disabled, and rehabilitative services. So in the curative or remedial, as the two words itself suggest, that curing something, the problem which is already there. Now in social work profession, we need to find a cure or a remedy to the particular problem. That is why the first function of social work is curative or remedial is in nature. Second one is correctional function. Correctional, the word itself means to rectify. So correctional social work has three broad areas. First one is individual reform services, which includes prison reform, probation, parole, and other related services. Correctional function includes those services where a person has to go through certain reformation. And these are the services that are provided to a particular individual or a group. Secondly, under correctional function is services for strengthening and improving relationship. For example, family welfare services, school social work, and industrial social work, where certain reformations are required. Certain development is required or change is required within the system to rectify certain things. That is the main objective of correctional function of social work. Then thirdly, services for social reform like employment services, prevention of prostitution, beggary, provision services, and removal of untouchability, that is to do away with social evils. That is the second objective of our second function of social work under the correctional function. Next, we go to the preventive function. Prevention services include life insurances, public assistance, social legislation, labor welfare, adult education, and prevention of diseases. The word preventive itself suggests that in order to prevent certain problems from happening, that is why it is known as the preventive function. Therefore, the examples that we see here, like life insurance, public assistance, social legislation, labor welfare, are all preventing the occurrence of certain social problems. Next function is developmental function. Developmental tasks are socio-economic developmental activities, education, recreational services, urban, rural development programs, and program for integration, that is looking for development of a particular region or a country. Next, we go to the methods of social work. After understanding the definitions of social work, what is social work, the objectives of social work as a profession and a discipline, then we studied the functions of social work. Now let us move on to the methods of social work. When we talk about method, a method can be defined as an orderly way of doing certain things, or an orderly way of procedure in which things are carried out with a particular aim. So as we had discussed in the objectives of social work, it is mainly to deal with humanitarian needs and to provide social justice to the society. So keeping that objective in mind, certain methods are there in social work, total 6 methods. 3 of them are primary methods and 3 are secondary methods. Each technique, each method uses different therapeutic models or strategies to deal with the social issues. There are 6 in total. Let us come to the first 3, which are known as the primary methods of social work, starting with number 1, social casework, number 2, social group work, 3, community organization. These 3 are the primary methods of social work, while social action, social welfare administration, and social work research are the secondary methods of social work. The first 3 methods of social work are the primary ones, as already mentioned. And let us start with social casework here. So casework was first defined and identified by Mary Richmond in 1922 in her book Social Diagnosis, where she defined casework as those processes which develop personality through adjustments consciously affected individual by individual between men and their social environment. Social work or casework is known as social work practice with individuals. The method enables social functioning of individuals which focuses on one-to-one relationship. The caseworker deals with people and situations one by one. So casework, as the word itself suggests, that it is focusing on one particular case or one individual problems. So the study is on an individual and identifying the therapeutic models to deal with the individual's problems. So the caseworker deals with people and situations one by one. When a client comes to a caseworker, he or she has to look into mainly 4 components. The 4 components are person, problem, place, and process. So the person is the client who comes with the particular problem, that is the second component. So the focus has to be on the problem. Thirdly, the place where the problem has occurred and where the client is meeting up with the caseworker. And process is the technique or the strategy that has to be applied to deal with the individual's problems. Secondly, we go to social group work. It is the second primary method of social work. It uses group as a medium of therapy to modify and enhance social behavior. So when individuals with similar problems come together, the social worker has to make sure that certainly there will be provisions where discussing or relating with each other's problems, individual problems, will bring about certain kind of help for each other in the group work process. It is a method that uses group as a medium of therapy to modify and enhance social behavior. Group work is applied to assist individuals to enhance their social functioning in a group setting to cope more effectively with the social environment. So here what happens is individuals with similar problems come together. There is the group worker to guide them, and the group process takes place to modify and to therapy which is given in the form of group. It is accomplished through groups which have power to enhance problem solving capacity, to prevent the development of serious social problems, and to restore and maintain social functioning of members. So here, as we have understood, the individuals with similar problems come together as a group. There is the group worker who guides and takes forward the group processes, and that is how group work is carried on with individuals with similar problems. Thirdly, there is community organization. It is the third primary method of social work. It is a method of intervention whereby a professional change agent helps a community action system, which comprises of individuals, groups, and organizations, to engage in planned collective action in order to deal with social problems within the democratic system of values. So, community organization focuses on a community problem. Here, the social worker is the main resource mobilizer or the professional change agent, as mentioned here, which gives community action system that comprises of individuals, groups, and organizations in the community to engage in planned collective action. So here, the role of a social worker is of being a leader, a resource mobilizer, and also an individual from the community can be nominated to play a leadership role in the process of community organization. It is a long-term process whereby people who are marginalized or living in poverty work together to firstly identify the needs, the desire to create change, to exert influence in the decisions which affect their lives, and work to improve the quality of their lives and the communities in which they live. So here, there is a definition given by Gingrich, which defines community organization as the process by which the social system of the community provides for integration and adaptation within the community. The community organization here focuses on the social system of the community and resorts to integration of the different resources available in the community, first identifying them, strategizing policies and techniques to deal with the problems, and decisions are taken within the community. Therefore, here we see huge involvement of the community people with the leadership of maybe one or two from the community themselves. So decision power and strategy making completely lies with the community people along with the assistance of the social worker. Fourthly, the method of social work is social action. It is again a secondary method of social work. Social action is an organized group process that aims to deal with general social problems and enhancing social welfare by legislative, social, or economic progress. It consists of organized and legally permitted activities designed to mobilize public opinion, legislation, and administration in favor of socially desired objectives. So here, social action focuses on certain problems. It either aims to resist certain changes, which may be for the bad of the community, or it also enhances to fight for social justice, to bring about social change, and to create social movement for the betterment of the society. As it is mentioned here, it is an organized group process, and unity of the people is very important. These are mobilized with the guidance and the strategy of the social worker as well as the community at large, enhancing social welfare by legislative, social, or economic progress, fighting for economic progress, doing away with social evils, or fighting against certain changes which might harm the society. It consists of organized and legally permitted activities, we have to keep in mind that social protest or protest which takes the form of violence is not a democratic value here. It is considered that in social action, only the activities which are legally permitted and organized are to be favored in as a method of social work. Arthur Dunham defines social action as efforts to bring about change or prevent change in current social practices or situations through education, propaganda, persuasion or pressure on behalf of objectives believed by the social actionist to be socially desirable. The objective has to be socially desirable, but we have to keep in mind that it is within the democratic values of the society. There should not be use of violence. Though there is use of propaganda, persuasion or pressure, it has to be within the socially desirable areas or perspectives. Fifth, we come to social welfare administration. Social work requires an understanding of welfare as well as administration as a tool for achieving welfare. Welfare discourse has been changing dimensions from charity to needs, and now it's rights-based approaches. So social work, as we know, is also a composition of administration here, where the linking of resources is not only based on charity, it's not only based on philanthropy, but also administration or management of available resources or strategies to create resources is an important aspect in social work. Therefore, social welfare administration is defined as a method used by those who has administrative responsibility to determine organizational goals for social agency or other units. Acquiring resources and allocating them properly to carry out a program, to coordinate activities towards achieving selected goals, and monitor, assess, and make necessary changes in the structure or to improve the effectiveness or efficiency of a system is important here. Therefore, in administration, we see that proper allocation of resources or management of resources, of procuring resources, and how management of people, management of resources are important to achieve the welfare objective of social work is achieved through social welfare administration. Development planning of a society or a country, state or a region is an integral part of social welfare and its administration. Therefore, when we plan about developing a particular region, development planning needs a lot of strategies and lot of skills, which is also an important method of social work. We see social welfare administration in all non-governmental and governmental organizations. Social welfare administration is the key to achieving success of organized social welfare activities. The last method of social work is social work research. Research is the basic foundation that gives rise to knowledge. So, social work research is an indispensable method that enhances the scope of social work practice. Without the knowledge base, a profession cannot survive. A profession cannot grow. Therefore, social work research is the basic foundation on which social work practice is built and models are built based on the database that is achieved through research. Research provides an in-depth understanding of a particular problem identified and thus contributes to the knowledge system. It provides information about a particular individual, who is the client, about the client's situation, a group or a community problem. So research is very important here. Social work research is an important stream of research as it not only strives to penetrate or get into the deeper roots of social issues, but also tries to find solving techniques for such issues. So social work research is not only a descriptive research, it is also an action research which focuses on building strategies and techniques to solve social issues. Social workers continuously access data from multiple resources, file the progress of clients, in individual or group interactions, and write reports. These are documented and recorded. Social work research draws heavily from such primary data as well as secondary data. So therefore, the last part is talking about how data is generated. For primary data consists of case files, one-to-one interaction, the transcripts that are written based on the observation and interaction with a client. These are known as case files, or these are known as the primary methods of research. The secondary data focuses on books, articles, and research, which is done by someone else but is a great knowledge base for social work research. So in today's class, we have discussed about what is social work, the definitions of social work, the objectives of social work, what are the different functions, and the six methods of social work. Thank you.